After sailing northwest across the Adriatic, we arrived in the Italian port of Ancona, the present city founded by Greek settlers from Syracuse in about 387 BC, who gave it its name. Ancona stems from the Greek word ankon, meaning elbow, as the harbour was originally protected by a promontory shaped like an elbow. We begin to explore. It appears there's a wedding in the church of Santa Maria. We then walked through the narrow medieval streets to the Piazza del Plebiscito and the Church of San Domenico. The local government offices are here, and the clock tower. It's a pretty place, but the weather is dull and cloudy. The statue is Pope Clement XII. There's a museum here too. The interior of the church was beautiful. We had read that this was an interesting city full of fascinating alleyways and medieval buildings. Cities built on a hillside tend to be like this. Typical guardians over the entrances. Impressive buildings. As we ascend, we get great views over the harbour. Our ship had docked in the port right next to the city, so we walked off the ship and were immediately in the center of town. From up here we can see the Arch of Trajan, a marble structure that is one of the finest surviving Roman monuments. It was built in the year 114 and named in honor of Trajan, the emperor who had made the harbour. It's still an iconic landmark for ships approaching the port. At the top of the hill, the cathedral, dedicated to Judas Syriacus, and completed in 1189. Built of grey stone in the Romanesque style. The facade has a Gothic entrance. It's actually built on the ruins of an ancient pagan temple dedicated to the goddess Aphrodite. Indeed, an impressive building. There's a legend that the painting of Mary, Queen of All Saints, has eyes that have been seen moving. In 1797, during the conquest of Ancona, Napoleon seized the painting and other sacred objects. But he then personally witnessed the miracle and returned everything to the cathedral. There's a crypt below the cathedral where rests the visible remains of Saint Ciriaco, the patron saint of the city. His remains were transferred to Ancona in the 5th century, but there's an exciting legend that states that his body is said to have been propelled in a coffin off the coast of Ancona and was pulled from the reeds by sailors with ropes. Afterwards, Nate got busy planning our next stop and admiring the magnificent church.
The sun has finally arrived, but it's been a very fascinating place. Alleyways and looking around the cathedral here has been a lot of fun.
The adjacent Roman amphitheatre was built in the Augustan period, late 1st century BC, early 1st AD, overlooking the harbour. It had more than 20 terraces on three layers and is estimated to have been able to accommodate up to 10,000 spectators. We were able to view it from the road, but we were certainly disappointed that it was not open to visitors. It was surely the most interesting part of the city. Places like this cost a lot to excavate and restore, and it would have been wonderful to contribute via an entrance fee and walk around these 2,000-year-old ancient ruins. Then strolled back through the city to the port, this time in the sunshine. Looking forward to Venice tomorrow and splitting Croatia the day after.